The legend of Rubenstock lives on. It returns. He's never left. He's still here. Hope you guys are ready for a very fun game. February 1st of 2019 was a very different time for Age of Empires. It was a much smaller community. And, you know, like all esports, there's an established meta. And Rubenstock, who had been doing it in rated games, decided to go crazy with a town center drop in a big tournament. It was back in the Escape Tourney days. And against one of the best teams in the world, Aftermath, with players like Hera and Leary and MBL. He went for town center drops for Team Finland. It was tremendous, and it worked wonders. That was on the map Chaos Pit, which is actually in the 2v2 World Cup, which is happening right now. But anywho, that's besides the point. Rubenstock, he became famous then. I actually met him about a year after that upload. And when I met him, he said that he was really hoping that this would be uploaded to YouTube. He's like, oh man, when you uploaded it to YouTube, I couldn't wait to see the comments. And that video now has 200,000 views, and so many people love him. And he's such a nice guy. He deserves all the credit that's coming his way. But anyways, Rubenstock's known for out-of-the-box strategies, and in particular the town center drop. And Rubenstock recently started streaming, and he's been going with wacky strats. Because that's what people want to see, and that's what he's good with. So he had a day recently where he only played Persians. And so he's here in the red, and he's playing on Gold Rush, a map we will see a lot over the next few weeks of YouTube content. And he's up against Skogo, who is, I think you could say he's top five in Germany. You have, like, Nilly, Jordan, Running, and then probably Skogo, right? Comes to mind. Skogo, he really likes Arena. He hangs out with the clowns, as they call themselves, the guys who like the arena map, but he's quite good on open maps as well, and in the top 100 ranking in the world. So, quality player here. He's playing Aztecs, as I think I already said. So, this is going to be an interesting matchup, because Persians, it doesn't feel like they fare all that well against Aztecs. Aztecs can get monks, eagles, and pikemen, and Persians can really struggle against that. I suppose with the Persian economy, you can definitely get a lead in games because the town centers do work faster in feudal and castle. But in my experience, if we're talking tournaments with free pick, on a map like Gold Rush, the civs you see are Britons, Mayans, Aztecs, Chinese, I could go Slavs maybe, but you know, as I go down that list, Persians isn't really on the list. It's more in the middle there, and so Rubenstock went for Persians because he felt like it'd be fun. And Skogo, he went for Aztecs because he knows Aztecs is just unstoppable at times. Now, Aztecs in particular are unstoppable if they can get the walls down. One thing Persians can do is use their mobility. Only 7 tiles of gold next to each player's town center on this map, so focus will definitely need to be on the middle. And these 7 tiles could easily be walled in for Skogo if he wants to form an arena, like a wall here, wall across here, and he's already making militia. Aztecs also start with more gold, so you can mass the militia. And not knowing when I'm uploading this, I think I'm uploading this before, like right before the 2v2 World Cup completes on the 19th and 20th of December. But anyways, a couple days ago, you had another upload to watch with Wolf Rushing, so this won't be in the title. But yeah, Skogo figures, why make a ton of militia when I can just take the wolves to Rubenstock's base and the wolves can do all the work for me? It's kind of a wimpy wolf lore, but 1 militia, 2 wolves, and Rubenstock is on the way to Feudal Age. I know what you were expecting, YouTube. You saw the title, and you figured, okay, this is going to be, he's going to lead his town center in Feudal Age, Dark Age, and he's going to rebuild it next to the enemy TC because Persian town centers have more HP, blah, 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 blah. I've seen it all before. No, Rubenstock actually wanting to play this standard. And this is a scout build. So this is what Rubenstock can see. He sees the militia attacking his villager. I have to say, this is one of the most pathetic wolf lores I've ever seen in my life. I say that with respect to Skogo and his talents. That could have been better. The militia dies. The villagers were completely fine. I guess if the villagers didn't have loom, it would have worked out. But Rubenstock making the barracks, and this is a scout build. The plan is to make stable, make some scouts, but against Rushfast Castle, normally those walls will be up. Aztec player hoping to use the secure gold and go up towards Castle Age eventually. But let's see what Rubenstock's able to do. Rubenstock very late to scouting Skogo's base. But the walls are not down for Skogo yet. Will anything Skogo wrong here? I'm sorry. Don't dislike the video. Don't do it. All right. I can't help it, man. It's like, I'm not a father. I don't know if there's any fathers or mothers or anyone who has children out there, right? But the thing is dad jokes. And my father growing up would always make cringy jokes. And it would make me cringe and want to run away from home forever. I exaggerate. But anyways, I never really understood why someone would make super cringy jokes until I had a large audience and realized how much power I feel when I can say a couple words and instantly affect people to that degree around me. So anyways, I apologize. I really should know better. And Rubenstock being annoying here, but the villagers have loom. It was wise from Skogo, who has played arena thousands of times, to have multiple villagers here just in case that scout would get too aggressive. And this is also interesting, the eagle's there. And if the eagle's sitting there, this is brilliant, actually. If the eagle's sitting there, it will only 1v1 a scout, and the eagle should do pretty good there. And then the town center could also range. Now, there was some idle time, but I don't think I've seen anything like that recently. Skogo dropping the tower and bailing on the tower and now dropping the tower on the gold. Yeah, one big thing you can do against this type of a play is a tower rush, because they have no military. So they wall, you can tower their berries, tower their gold. So Skogo, he's formed an arena on non-arena maps enough times to know this. And look at Rubenstock. Now, it's Rubenstock. Rubenstock, he likes towers, I'm sure. But he might be thinking about something else. So let's see what happens. Now, again, Rubenstock's a legend for town center drops. How he town center drops, how he reads the game, all these things, very unique. He's starting with the tower. Now, tower, that will range the gold. Tower will also range some of these farms. Skogo, it doesn't make a player look all that convincing when they play this passive on an aggressive map, right? Doing his best to save up some resources, but now he's thinking, I need to play defense, so he goes to stone. I don't know how this villager got out here, actually. It might have ejected through there. It's a little bit of a bug, but another tower for Rubenstock. Now, when I first saw this game, the whole time I'm thinking he was going to town center drop right there. But I also wasn't sure if he town center dropped here, if he'd be able to range the enemy TC. So another thing you might not know about Rubenstock, he plays the game with a cube mod. So like the trees are green blob. This is a gray blob. Everything's a cube, right? It looks horrible. But he does it because it simplifies the game and he's able to, I don't know, understand it better. Double blacksmith for Skogo. Oh my goodness, Skogo's under so much pressure. Two blacksmiths. That awkward moment when you build one blacksmith so far away, you forget about the other one. But look at this. He builds a palisade wall over top of that tree. So that tree's gone. And it looks like Rubenstock, who will take this villager out, is going to just run in with the scouts, right? Run in with the scouts. Wait a second. What's going on? Oh, there's no town center here. What? What? Excuse me? Town center. So I don't know if it's because of his brilliance and experience with town center's range, but he knew that the town center had to be this close to be able to range the enemy town center. Rubenstock, with 29 villagers, when you delete your town center and can't produce villagers, that does set you back, but also has killed some, and Skogo seems to really be struggling currently. So Skogo will lose another one, maybe later. And now the game plan for Rubenstock is to garrison this town center, a person town center having 4,800 HP. And then just shoot down Skogo's town center. Skogo, his town center, has 2,400 HP. This is why this strategy is called the Persian douche, because first time it happened, the person who received the town center job had a few choice words for the enemy. Now, look at how much of a pest Rubenstock is. You can actually take out farms before they've started to be farmed, because they're on 1 HP. It's essentially like a castle on 1 HP, and you just doink it. So that was 60 wood down the drain for Skogo. Skogo now making the market. And Skogo has a villager lead, Rubenstock, who researched fleshing, by the way. Is made a forward archer range, and I think has just gone to gold at home. Completely open over here, and I guess is considering making archers to send them into the towers, which are also hitting the TC, and maybe even the town center. Like, wouldn't the scouts have been enough, YouTube? This is what's crazy about a player like Rubenstock. I feel like the scouts could have been enough. Yeah, I mean, you get the scouts in, you have the towers up, you continue to tower, you don't need to send that many villagers forward, but it's the extra level of commitment, the guts, to eventually gain the glory that really sets Rubenstock apart. But I also think that so many of us, when we play this game, we think about what we should and should not do. And that's based on what we have seen before. And the Finland players in particular, like Max, Velez maybe not so much, but Max and Rubenstock, and then maybe you got to give Jupe or Yupe a shout. They just say, it's not what I've seen happen, it's what should happen based on this, 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 and this. 37 villagers for Rubenstock, who is very far from ever clicking up to the next age. And you have Skogo, and it has not looked pretty, but honestly, Skogo, 38 vills versus 37, has continued to repair the town center, and the town center will be standing. And Skogo's on stone. So Skogo can just castle drop this TC, and a castle has the same amount of HP, but fires a lot more and should take down that town center no problem. So Skogo in the lead, and Rubenstock's going to run in. Rubenstock, realizing that this could be dangerous, is sending the archers in. Now, check this out. The archers will be in a perfect spot. I don't know how, but the town center micro from Skogo was beastly there. Like, sometimes it feels like town centers have ballistics. Now, that's an accidental town bell for Skogo. And now, what is... Now, you have Rubenstock with a forward archer range between woodlines, gold, and town center. And behind enemy lines. This is such a wacky game. There will be a comment, win or lose, from Skogo later, which I think you guys are really going to want to look for. But yeah, pay attention to the rest of this game, because it's wild, man. Rubenstock in feudal age, making scouts and archers, and you have Skogo with the stone to drop a castle, and also some gold and wood to make siege. It really is not looking like it's going to be an easy time. Or Rubenstock, a fan favorite, sure. But this is almost too crazy. Now, would you feel disrespected, YouTube? They're around the same level with ranking. I think Rubenstock recently lost a bunch of points because he's been going for wacky strats. Would you feel disrespected? Or would you just say, nope, it's part of the game. He just went for a really odd strategy. I don't know if I would feel disrespected, but I would feel flustered. I think, if anything, it's a sign of respect if Rubenstock does this to you, right? It's like if Doubt fails a castle against you. Respect. It finally happened. Happened to me this time. Respect to Skogo. Skogo is defended from this very well. 39 villagers, only behind by 6 villagers, and now has a castle here. Yeah, say goodbye to your town center, Rubenstock. Now, I think this is a mistake from Skogo. He probably tried to click that villager and accidentally clicked the range and has just now realized the mistake. But yeah, that tower needs to be taken care of. And then so does that archer range. Just hear arrows after arrows after arrows after arrow after arrow. A tower over here now. Rubenstock, by the way, has been mining the stone from Skogo. He's also taken some of the bushes there. I did watch this moment, and I think Skogo accidentally killed one or two of his own villagers there, and these are also very weak. And nice attack round. That's the arena micro right there, isn't it? To attack around those archers. If Rubenstock wants to, though, the scout could take out these villagers, and that villager could also do so, but I don't know if Rubenstock has plans for that. Instead, we have stone walls and a gate, which doesn't really make sense because there's a scorpion out there. But okay, whatever floats your boat, Rubenstock. Rubenstock now is in feudal age against Gogo. And okay, tower just took out that Maganel. Awkward, but is this scout's micro nerding and dodging fire? The reality is you need to be in castle age to compete with Aztecs, right? And Rubenstock soon will not have a town center. The archer's here. He's still making them. He's now going to place a tower here. Skogo, very good defensively, I have to say. Notices that. Will drop a tower of his own. Here the villagers from Rubenstock are trying to place another tower. A tower that really should not go up. Let's see what happens, though. Well, they're just fighting for now. This one's dead. He's walling around the mining camps to be a pest. Just to make it less efficient. Microing that villager back. She dies. This villager will probably die. Here you have villagers in the tower. Skogo is still focused on this, I suppose. And is losing villagers in the process. This is what happens when you play Rubenstock. It just becomes a mess. It's like a normal game was inside of a pinata. And you just... Someone whacks that pinata. Rubenstock whacks the pinata and the game just goes everywhere. Except unlike the candy you would have wanted to eat growing up, it's like raw vegetables. I'm sorry, I'm weird. I apologize. That didn't make a whole lot of sense, but maybe I was just a weird kid. Okay, archers. Like, look, he's microing amongst towers, scorpions, and a castle. It's so silly. It's so silly, man. But you really need to buy time at this point, right? I mean, you need to buy so much time because of how bad this situation is going to be for yourself. Here goes Rubenstock after losing that town center. Oh, now just drop a TC in the middle. So we'll place another tower here a little further back. Let's check Skogo's economy. Skogo has 8 on food, 4 on gold, 3 on stone, and is now going to make some eagles. Eagle Maganel Monk, that's the combo I talked about earlier. But Rubenstock is going on the way to Castle Age! I wish I would have shown it. However, yeah, look at that price. He bought a lot of food. He was actually using the gold income to buy resources. He does not have a lot on food. So, I mean, it's Gold Rush. The gold's going to be there. You probably want to make knights and or light cav, but you can't afford that if you're in Rubenstock's spot. These villagers are so very weak. The eagles and spears chasing them down. One villager down. Skogo, I guess, finally can breathe. I really want to apologize, by the way, to everyone watching this video. I know that a lot of you guys come here to de-stress. This probably is not helped with that, so... apologies if this only brought more stress onto your day, but maybe it's one of those deals where if someone else is experiencing the stress, it's fine. You know, I forget what comedian made the joke. It's probably been said by a bunch of comedians, let's be honest, but it's something like, sometimes watching other people struggle in life can make you feel better about your own life. That's not the joke. Otherwise, the person wouldn't be a very successful comedian, but that's the gist. Scout will not do much. Not too much at all. Poor Rubenstock. I really wish that town center drop would have accomplished a bit more, right? Because it was so ballsy. There's reasons why those crazy plays just shouldn't be a thing. And so now Skogo still has gold to mine. Still plenty. Thousands of gold to mine. Skogo will continue his little push here and actually loses the Maganel. Okay. Rubenstock has 2 on food, 26 on gold. These villagers at home, they really need to be farming, I'd say. Now, you could try and add a second TC and boom, but I don't think it's worth it. then you're putting food income into villagers when you need food income into something to kill this force. Example, the game that I uploaded with the Wolf Rush a few days ago. I guess Rubenstock noticed because of the cube mod that there's a hole here and is simply going to sneak in and get some snipes. Skogo reacts to it, but Skogo lost a few villagers there. Skogo down to 40 now. Rubenstock with some random stables. This one next to the market. This one here on the hill. And the other one at home. Skogo now with a few monks. Now, Aztec monks get more HP. Every single technology that's researched. Still costs 100 gold to make a monk, though. There's no discount there. So you don't want to be too wasteful with these things. I can tell that Rubenstock really wants to play tower defense. Guard towers are a tremendous idea against Mackinel pushes. I forget the exact cost as the wolves are attacking Rubenstock's villagers, but it's something like 200 food, 100 wood, or maybe it's 300, 200, but you need food and wood, and those are the resources that Rubenstock does not have available right now. Also, he would need the university. So the towers themselves having bodkin arrows is nice. Even has the leftover archers inside those towers, but the reality is, even though it might take some time, they could easily see this town center going down. The Rubenstock would just place another one. What do we have here? Five towers in the middle, two TCs. And then over here, scorpions are raiding that wood line. This is a nice little moment, though, for Rubenstock. Picked off some eagles and immediately made a scout after hearing the monk. And let's see. Really poor from Skogo not to have Sanctity. And actually, as I say, that Sanctity comes in. So now 50 HP on the monks instead of just 30. What a weird game. Now, there's the university, but pay attention to the lack of food and wood. That is a problemo. Salam. All right. Skogo update. Over here? But nay. These villagers actually cannot drop off wood currently. Or something. Did he... They're trapped in there. He must have pulled them to go build something. Oh, that's what he did. He pulled them to go build something and they got stuck. Okay, and actually the only reason he realized that was because the knight went in there. Okay. I think I know what they wanted to build. 691 stone for Skogo. Stono Castle. Now, I wish as a caster I could see if he could have placed it on the elevation. My guess is he couldn't. I'm not sure if that would have been the play, but a bit closer would also be very nice. But much like before, we've seen town centers do go down to castles. Rubenstock, faster producing TCs with Persians. He's simply buying food. 208 gold to buy 100 food right now. That price will only get higher. But yeah, more eco. Still no real response to the castle drop and the siege and the eagles and the spears and the monks. Such a shame. Not a shame if you're Skogo. Skogo, like I said, will probably have been stressed, probably not enjoying his time too much. It depends on the player. Look at Rubenstock. Rubenstock trying again. Skogo's probably like, get out of here. Shoo fly, don't bother me. But it's wise thinking from Rubenstock. What do I say all the time? If you're struggling in an important area of the map, make the opposition think about the other side. You know, make them think about their eco instead of the important area. Three TCs soon in the middle for Rubenstock. University is on fire. I'm sure all the children have evacuated. But no guard tower upgrade. Still only one Mackinel for Skogo, who is running kind of low on stone. Or not stone. Well, I guess that's true as well, but what I meant to say there, gold. Eagles and spearmen. These are just eagle scouts, so I think it's a little questionable to fight under this many towers. Skogo perhaps desperate. This is ridiculous, just looking now at what Skogo can see. This almost doesn't feel like a game. You know, it feels like a completely different game. Doesn't feel like Age of Empires 2. Actually, YouTube, I'm curious on if you'd be okay with me casting with cubes. at one point. I felt like I was going to cast this with cubes, but then if 70% of people would realize it's only going to happen every once in a while, 30% might still not like it, you know? I think a lot of you guys probably appreciate the fact that someone plays with cubes and might not want to see it. And look at the KD. The Town Center and Towers did work there. Now, a lot of people watch this game on YouTube and Twitch, but they don't play it. So I'll tell you, in this position, as a high-level player, Skogo probably has... He has an idea for what to do from most situations. And I kind of touched on this previously, but... Because this is such an uncommon situation to face... Actually, Skogo could just take this gold, I guess. You kind of lose track of a lot of small details. That's why players who thrive on messy games can do so well against meta players, because the meta players, they never encounter the meta situations. So Rubenstock, he's able to freely read the situation and figure out, oh, okay, I've done this 12 other times. I know what to do, or just has an uncanny ability of understanding. Like right now, he's very well aware that there's woodchoppers over here. So he sent a knight there, I guess, to see if there's an overchop. Did just complete the light cav upgrade, and now is going to make another university. 36 on gold, 5 on food. 5 on freaking food. But 71 villagers for Rubenstock. See if these towers can stay up, though. Skogo using so many vills to repair Mackinels. It looks crazy, but it's the right play. Take down as many towers as possible. Also looks crazy that maybe these villagers would be repairing. That's also the correct play for Rubenstock. Rubenstock's probably buying stone as well. Let's be honest. He does not have a lot of stone available at home. And has mined most of that stone forward at this point. So many town centers costing stone. So such an expensive situation for Rubenstock to be in. And can't help but feel like Rubenstock would have wanted those towers to be up and be guard towers about 5 minutes ago. But guard tower makes a massive difference in range and attack. And you can see it right there. Guard tower sniping a Mackinel. And Skogo now will have to think twice about engaging against this many towers. Now, meanwhile, Skogo came out here to the stone thinking, oh, I can take that. No, you can't, actually. Rubenstock's there. Rubenstock. In a stable over here. Still thinking about constricting on the main eco of Skogo. Skogo making a ram. I can't help but feel like Skogo really needed to keep those eagles and spearmen alive and turn that into eagle warrior with rams. Then again, I suppose Rubenstock could make siege. It's just so freaking awkward to know. Like, this is the main eco for Rubenstock. This is what should be his main eco, I guess. And look! Over top of the wood line, Rubenstock just checked and sent the knight in. It's easy for us to say that that should be noticed, but... Skogo's really focused on paying attention to this army, trading vills out of his TC. He's definitely frazzle-dazzled here. Frazzle-dazzled sounds like a good thing, like razzle-dazzle. But when I say frazzle-dazzle, that means that you're confused. He just sent these villagers back to work by pressing the hotkey, which is normal after you eject, you put villagers in the TC, excuse me. But you don't want to do that when you just sent them from this area. Thankfully, the knight will go down. At least it seems like it. We have a villager building a tower over here. For Rubenstock, Skogo might just need to pony up and say, forget about the middle, I'll take your gold. You know? Like, I mean, he's not really spending the gold. I think he can use a lot more eagles. He actually needs food more than anything. And funny enough, can't justify buying food at these prices. Rubenstock is ruining the economy. Skogo. 1, 2 town centers here. And I can't help but feel like, oh no! As Rubenstock comes in, he kills 3 monks. He'll take out some of the siege. Oh, this light cav were so worth it. Yeah, I can't help but feel like it's hilarious that Skogo is trying to attack this area. 5 villagers here. Of the 89 now that Rubenstock has. My word, there's another TC over here. That tower will eventually deny that wood line. I just heard a conversion somewhere. Oh, actually, Rubenstock just used his villagers to take out a ram, as he now is going to try and push in even further with more towers. I guess it's to deny the 600 gold that's there. This is funny, though. Skogo is placing a forward barracks in here. Like, I'm gonna raid you. That's what you would normally do. I don't think that's the play right now, Skogo. Finally, he just got sick of this, I'm sure, and wants to place a town center out here on the stone. And I get that. Expanding even to secure the woodline would have been good. Finally, he's adding more farms. We really need to add more farms. And here we have another tower from Rubenstock. Let's check the prices again. Yeah, it's really expensive to buy stone, too. It must be buying stone. No murder holes for Rubenstock. There are monks going for conversions on the villagers. I feel like if murder holes is in, this could be an epic moment for Rubenstock. Because you could kill the villagers attacking his tower as he repairs. But unless I missed it, yeah, it doesn't look like murder holes is in. Oh, it's now coming in. Okay, so Rubenstock realizes the need for murder holes. Best tech in the game. And I guess that tower will go down for now. But there's another tower over here, so I guess the other one wasn't good enough. Rubenstock with 91 vills. And now 18 farms. So he's got the food eco to back up the gold eco. And tremendous amounts of map control. Villagers are dying here. Oh, no. 4 farmers and 1 idol. 2 barracks for that poor Skogo. Because it looks so silly for us to see that. Skogo, he might as well be Scotty. He just doesn't know. He just doesn't realize how crazy this game has been for him. Rubenstock's still mining a lot of stone. And Rubenstock is sending in the villagers to drop a tower here. Now, there's a funny thing where, as the knights are again back over here, he swoops in at the proper time, Skogo garrisons. But there's a funny thing that the town center droppers had to figure out at one point through experience. And it's that score can be a lie sometimes. As Skogo will now try and get some farm eco out here next to the castle. And is at 50 villagers. When you town center drop, your score goes down really low. So it looks bad. But if you read the situation for what it is and realize that maybe over the next 15 to 20 minutes, you're going to have more map control, then it's not that big a deal. Whereas, again, it's a more simplistic approach of, I need eco. I'm allowing them to have a lead in eco. This is bad. You know, that's an approach that most players tend to have. All right, so, I mean, 89 villagers for Rubenstock, who went for scouts, towers, archers, TC drop on Gold Rush. Then turn that into this. I mean, if this game continues any longer, there won't be any gold in the middle of the map. Absolute full map control for Rubenstock. Every time Skogo makes a move, Rubenstock is there. Look, knight here, attacking villagers. Tower's here, on woodline. Tower here, on gold. Tower going to shoot down this tower. Tower here, on stone. Tower here, on woodline. You know, with the way that this guy's able to read the map, I'd say all these good things because these villagers are about to go down, but I'm beginning to feel like I should try out the cube mod. Just to see. Just to see if I can pick up on some of the crazy details. Not much easier. Here we have a tower that will complete. Of course, murder holes is in, so expect that monk to go down. Skoko's at 54 bills and is spending half the time reacting to these annoying little towers and raids. And it really doesn't seem like Skogo, despite having all that score lead, can do much right now. Rubenstock just needs knights now, right? You need knights with the light cav to take out the eagles. And before, the food eco wasn't there. Now the food eco will be here for Rubenstock. How many stables? 1, 2, 3, 4. There's a fifth one here. Lots of stables. Just placing stables wherever he feels you might need a stable. Big upgrades on the way. Ram even on the way. Another tower being placed here as Skogo's using his town center to shoot down this one. Okay, I'm going to go to Skogo's point of view and just look as he's about to imp He's about to imp. Doesn't really have gold. But just look at all the blinking areas of the map for a second. Those are all the areas he's being attacked currently. That's nuts. And it's actually... You would assume that's going to get worse if Rubenstock starts sending the knights out as well. Like, there will be attack signals here as well. Good job from Skogo to somehow get up to imp. If the Mackinels won't do it and Rams won't do it, maybe Trebs will do it. But it definitely is that classic situation where you put most of your resources into Imperial. What can you make when you're there? Rubenstock repairing the ram. I think the ram will go down. That's a lot of villagers. But it's ideal to pull the few villagers you have to attack a ram, and then you have to focus elsewhere because the knights are attacking your monk. That's some gold right there. There we go. That's a trickle of gold for you, Skogo. The towers are, for some reason, prioritizing the blacksmith. I thought they fixed this bug, but I tend to not believe patch notes. They should be prioritizing villagers, unless Rubenstock clicked the blacksmith, which might have happened. So scorpions went down there. Pikemen are here. Skogo making more monks. Skogo really needs gold. And maybe this gold could have been an option. That might be where Skogo's going right now, actually. Just drop a town center there if you can get the wood for it. I don't know about that, actually. Where can Skogo even take wood right now? Not here, not here. Rubenstock's just taking all the resources. And Rubenstock must sense that this is going to be the gold that Skogo goes to. Yeah, look at the villagers. Not really a sense, I guess, when you can see it. But we'll place a guard tower here and say, no, no, no. I might not be taking that gold, but you know that's mine, you thief. Murder Hulls is going to be so epic here. Especially if he focuses down the pikemen, because then the knights can... Oh, yeah. Repairing the tower. Skogo doesn't know where to go. Skogo doesn't know where to go. Cannot take wood. Can barely take stone. I don't even know where that is. It says he has 3 stone miners. I have no clue. Here? No? It must be idle. Wait a second. Here they are. Oh, so they're going to the stone. I see. Okay, so they're not stone miners anymore. They are dead men walking. He's trying desperately to get one trebuchet. And just spent wood on a lumber camp. And, okay. Rubenstock has a massive eco lead, still in Castle Age, has so many knights. Should be enough knights to take the fight against the pikemen and the monks. Big thing being, of course, as conversion comes in, that Rubenstock can afford to make a lot more, and Skogo does not have that luxury. Skogo making pikemen, which would be the proper unit, making monks, which would also be the proper unit. But Skogo now running back to the castle on the hill, which protects nothing except for a few farms that will actually expire. Like, that is insult to injury. You don't have wood for a treb, and then your farms start expiring to make it even worse. Phew. I'd be a little tilted. 140 pop for Rubenstock. 140 pop versus 58. Skogo may be playing on out of frustration at this point, or maybe genuinely feels like Imperial Age could give him some type of a way back into the game. He actually did it. Scouts, towers, into town center drop, into everything else. And I think Skogo is going to give you an idea of how he feels about the situation. He says, GG, thanks for the pleasurable game 11. Something tells me that is a kind way of saying playing you makes me want to rip my hair out. I have a lot of respect for Skogo, because I might have said worse. You know, nothing too aggressive. But, you know, I'm not going to break down the example, but I faced up against a wacky strat, and I really wasn't having the best morning, and I was like, oh, you're the worst, is what I said. But yeah, he says, Thanks for the pleasurable game 11. I hope we see that in the YouTube comments. I hope this was pleasurable for you guys. I hope you enjoyed watching this. I will plug Rubenstock's channel. I actually spoke to him a few weeks back. I was like, dude, stream, you know? But I know you guys might want to watch his YouTube video. So I'll see if I can get him upload his point of view and then maybe pop that into the description. Not even sure if he has a channel at this point. But what a ridiculous game, man. Rubenstock is a legend. When I saw or heard about the game, someone told me this is the game of the year. You have to watch this. And I was a bit conflicted because I already have uploaded a video that's titled The Best Game of 2020. Probably bad practice for me to upload that in the middle of 2020. I don't think this quite beat that. But anywho, point is, someone told me it was very good. Thanks, shout out to Ray for that. That was incredible. And wow, look at these stats. Look at the amount of stone and gold mined for Rubenstock. Still ended up having more food eco. I suppose if we were to break down what Skogo should do better there, it's just deal with the chaos. Get to Eagle Warrior instead of Eagle Scout. Pressure those towers before Guard Tower comes up. Definitely, he was on the clock there without gold, especially being Aztecs, and this was unable to break Rubenstock. Despite all this craziness, look at the uptimes, look at the populations. My word, what a game. All right, YouTube, so I actually have a lot of really cool YouTube-only videos that are coming towards you guys because I'm going to be off of streaming after the 2v2 World Cup for about a weekish to relax and enjoy the holidays a bit. So I'm going to give you a little plug here. I don't like to cram this down your throats. I know you guys might not want to watch the stream and all that, but it's big for me. You know, we put in a lot of focus on the 2v2 World Cup, and the games are going to be epic, so we'd love to have you on the live stream. It'll be this weekend. I know for people who are watching in the future, it might not be the case, but it'll be the 19th and 20th of December, the semifinals on the 19th, the third place match and finals on 20th of December 2020. Massive 2v2 World Cup, biggest teams, great prize pool, and hoping to break some numbers there. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching. Stop by, but also leave in the YouTube comments your thoughts on this game. I won't ask any specific question because there's just so much to process here, but I think Rubenstock might be a little bit divisive. Some people love him, some people think this is too much. Some people, they think happy thoughts until they face him. I don't know, and others might think it's a pleasurable game, but that's all for now. I will see you tomorrow with another upload, YouTube, and I will we're done now. I need to go to bed. This is too late.